In addition to the manual entry of self-determined member eccentricity, eccentricities can also be generated automatically. First, define which outer edge of the cross-section should be situated in the original member axis. Provided this point is not situated in this axis, but exactly at the height of an outer edge of another member, then define it by means of the transverse offset. This allows you to control whether profiles should be, for example, flush top or lie on each other. This type of input via relative offset has the advantage that the eccentricities are based on the cross-sections of the involved members and automatically adapt to changes. Thus, if you optimize cross-sections, you don't have to redetermine the eccentricities. These are always up to date. Member eccentricities are taken into account by transforming the degrees of freedom in the local element stiffness matrix and thus in the internal force determination. The example of a frame system shows how the member eccentricities influence the internal forces. This aspect should always be considered in your calculation, because it could result in unwanted offset moments in the structure as well.